In this video, guys, we're going to talk about trading with a trigger signal. Stay tuned. Hey guys, warm welcome to you. All right, so this video is sponsored by, links to them in the description are below. CFDs, spread bets, MT4, MT5, automated, you can have EAs with those, happy with scalping, all the good stuff you'd expect from a broker. Go and check them out. Of course, they're regulated, well-respected, well-regarded partner for us on the channel. All right, so in this video, guys, I do want to talk a little bit about trading with a trigger signal. Let's define that quickly, and then let's talk about what it's all about. This is, and why I'm kind of covering this video is because I think having this concept of approaching trading helps you loads avoid overtrading. It creates a kind of flexible framework with a binary event of I'm either taking the trade or I'm not. It helps you filter out some of the losing trades. It helps you make sure you get on winning trades. It helps you with the FOMO, helps you missing out, helps you have a defined strategy. I think even whether you choose to use kind of my approach or not to it, I think taking this nugget and blending it and using it as your own is some value too. So even if you don't decide, you don't like price action trading, you don't want to do any of that kind of stuff, fine. You want to keep it simple. I think still having a trigger signal for your trades is beneficial. So let me explain what I mean. So a trigger signal to me is a specific price movement or pattern that signals you to execute the trade. Okay, so it's something that's either happens or it doesn't. It's very binary. Does or it doesn't. It's true or it's false, which is good for us in terms of trading. Now, some of you are going to say, well, trading's not kind of got a lot of gray, it's not black and white. That's fine. We have a lot of the gray area before the trigger, and then we pull the trigger. So we have something that we always pull the trigger on if criteria is met. And that just helps you so much with overtrading. You're not going to overtrade something that doesn't have the trigger. It makes you easier to stick to your rules and be disciplined because you have a very simple trigger. And like me, you might have multiple triggers, but you decide to say, hey, this is my trigger. This is what I need to see before I will execute a trade. If I don't see it, I won't execute. Very simple to be much more focused and disciplined and stop breaking the rules. So let's just kind of have a very broad overview on this and give you some idea of what we're talking about here. So a trigger could be a wide range bar. You have to define that. That could be the biggest bar you've had for the past 5 minutes if you're on a 1 minute chart trading that. It could be the biggest bar you've had for the past week if you're swing trading on a daily chart. Define it, make it a binary event. Is it or isn't it? Could be an outside bar as well. You know, something that takes a high and low. Something that's obvious, pin bar, we know about pin bars. You know, if we've got to push through here, that kind of thing, again, define the pin bar. Don't leave it to chance and leave it ambiguous. Pin bar, 25% of the whole range of the body, etc., however you define it. Prior high cleared, so you've got a candlestick here, next day the prior high is cleared. Could be very simple like that. The prior low has cleared. The low has been one of my favorite ones, actually, an uptrend at the moment. Well, I'll say at the moment when you're watching this, it's December 2020. I've been fantastic for the last quarter-ish, taking out the prior low and coming back up. That's a trigger. Takes out the prior low, comes back up. Very simple, either does or it doesn't. Close above or below a key level. Again, waiting for the candlestick close. Imagine it's our key level. We don't want it just to tickle above there. We want to see it close. Again, a very binary event. Notice how this can be very flexible. And there's nothing new and surprising, exciting. This is not any novelty idea. It's just having this simple idea to pull the trigger. Now this is where it gets more interesting and where the value, I think, comes from for you. Is you think about all the markets we have. We've got all these markets and we're trying to find a trade. Now you may be, hopefully you're focused in, you're blinking in on one or two ideas and markets and times you're trading. And then you come into an idea zone. Now for me, this is what I call my filters, but for this video, let's talk about it in terms of ideas. So you might have a trade idea and you trade ideas, etc. So it doesn't have to be necessarily a chart pattern like it is for me, or something that sets up for me and passes my criteria saying it's a great idea. You could, with the power of this, you could generate it from the third party. You could generate it from a scanning tool. You could generate it from anything. And it comes then into your idea bucket. And only then, you're only allowed to execute your triggers that are in that idea bucket. So you can't trigger something that doesn't come into the ideas. And if it's in the idea, it still doesn't mean you take the trade. So it makes it very simple. This is where your flexibility comes in, because you can be like, you know, I think that market's going higher. I think we're going to go lower on this. Yes, we're tough, or we can be more strategic. and go, yeah, well, this is touching up a Bollinger Band, it's doing this, however you like to trade, we've got a big short float on this stock, whatever it may be, that can come into your idea bucket, and then you have a definite binary event that says, hey, I know that pin bars in this format are bullish, so I'm going to wait for that in line with my bullish trade idea. You get the idea, you're stacking up these different thought processes and trades. So if you look at a Venn diagram, for example, you've got the ideas bucket here or segment here, you've got the triggers segment here, and you only take a trade if both of those are met. This is where it gets interesting as well, why you can prevent yourself over trading, because number one, you're not going to pull the trigger on stuff that hasn't been actually triggered. You haven't got the pin buy, you haven't got the wide range buy, you haven't got your close above a key level, whatever it may be for you. But also, you know, if you're using the idea framework as well, you might get a trigger, you get pin bars all the time, but unless it's on a trade idea you've already done the analysis on, you're not gonna pull the trigger. So the power of combining these two means that you are far less likely to just shoot from the hip. You can be far more clinical with your research, doing your ideas, bring them into that bucket. And then again, far more disciplined and structured with your plan for some sort of trigger to actually execute the trade, rather than just seeing the idea, which many traders do. Guys, you're not alone with this. You get the idea and you immediately want to get in. Like, okay, that's a first step. I've got the idea. However I generate that, and I'm quite flexible with that myself as well. And I think that's a good thing to be, because you can use some intuition, you can use some strategy, you can put it into that idea bucket. But being strict and disciplined with the trigger side of it means that you can have more control over your trading, you can be more structured with your trading, and you know you're only pulling the trigger on something that's a good pattern, but it's only a good pattern on a good idea. And you're combining the two together. You're not just gonna pull the trigger on any old pin buy you see on this and that, that's not in your good idea bucket. So that's something to consider, guys. It works well for me. I know it's worked well for many other traders that kind of use this. Forget about that for now. Just a simple thing of have a couple of triggers and maybe use that and say, hey, this is what I'm gonna do, this is what I like to see, and it's very personal to you as well. It's what I like to see in the charts, what I like to see in price before I get involved. So I'm gonna make it a criteria because it's my money I'm risking. It's my hard-earned capital. I wanna grow my capital. I'm going to trade when the market is in line with what I want. I'm not just going to be a slave to the market and trade just because it's looking good. I need to see this, this, and this before I risk my money. And that could be a trigger signal. Take care, guys. See you the next one. Don't forget to check out our channel sponsor in the description. And while you're down there, write a comment. You like it, you don't like it, any ideas, any suggestions, any feedback, any thoughts on this? Always interested to hear what you've got to say. Take care. Bye-bye.